Well, Mike, just general thoughts on the game.
General thoughts on the game is that, it's an honor to play in the game. I think it was a great experience for our players. We've never had any of our players that never played in the game like this. And I thought that we got beat by a better team today. I think that, Rundle was better than us today. We split with them during the season, and we have not played them on our home court. And hopefully, if we get better and we can win a playoff game, then we'll have a chance to do that. But I thought they outplayed us today, and I thought we missed shots that a lot of times we make, and we were very, very poor from the line. And I think, we've got to, we went undefeated in our league, and everybody says we're, a really, really good team, which we are. But you also are a very, very young team. So I think if you look at our lineup, we have a lot of, younger kids. I think for them it was a really, really good experience. So we just got to reset. We're 0-0.
I didn't see you guys on Wednesday, but obviously I got glimpses of what happened from the kids yesterday. Did you see some of that continuation and missing those shots today?
I thought that we didn't shoot the ball exceptionally well, to be honest with you. I was probably, most disappointed in our free throws. We've been a really good free throw shooting team, and we didn't shoot the ball well at all. And it's huge. We're missing two free throws in a row, and it gives us a chance, to get into our press and get our defense set. And, we would have had a chance maybe to get back in the game if we could hit some free throws. But it's basketball. It's been a long week. It's our third game this week. It's, you saw us when we played here on Monday, and it was polar opposite. Shot the ball very, very well. So I just think that, it's hard. You get caught up in the moment, and, the county championship is a very odd game. It's not like a typical game. I was at Gwynn Park for 13 years and was blessed enough to play in four county championships. We won one, and we lost three. All three times we lost, we went to the Final Four, and the time we won, we lost that half-court shot to our arch rivals. So, we just got to regroup, and it's a little adversity for our players, and we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, and on that, how much do you just want to emphasize, moving forward? Because I know these boys do put a lot of pressure on staying perfect.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. But, we weren't perfect. We lost twice during the season.
Sure, but
so it wasn't like we were an undefeated team.
Yeah.
But, in the county, we were perfect. I think that, we started the process when I called a timeout with a minute left in the game and put our substitutes in and brought the team together. It's, they're young kids. I think sometimes people forget, some of these guys look like they're grown men, but at the end of the day, we got a lot of 16 and 17-year-olds, and we got a few 15-year-olds on the team, too. So I just think it's a good opportunity for them to reset. We'll have a couple days off. And, the mark is going to be, how are they going to do the next week of practice, and are they going to be able to go to another level? I would say, for me personally, I thought the difference in the game was Arundel's pressure. Their 2-1-2 bothered us, and I think it took us out of what we did. And I think that X and O-wise was the difference in the game, and all the credit goes to Arundel. They did an excellent job, and they played a really, really good game, and they shot the ball exceptionally well.
It's almost like when you guys tried to slow down, you slowed down a little too much, like you guys were holding on the ball a little too long.
Well, I don't agree with that. I thought that the times we did slow down and we made some adjustments, I thought we got pretty good shots. Some of those shots didn't go. There were a lot of 50-50 balls that didn't go our way and bounced into their hands, and that's just part of basketball. But I do think we started the game a little bit tight. I thought we missed shots early down, point-blank shots that we've made all season long. But how do you simulate this? You can't simulate this environment, during the regular season. You really can't. So I'd be really, really surprised if our players didn't grow from it, if they didn't get better from it, if they didn't respond. We got a very, very close-knit team. And I think we'll bounce back. I really, really do. It hurts right now, but I think once we get back to practice next week, and I think our guys will respond. The famous words of Morgan Wooten, who always was my idol as a young coach, and I was blessed enough to coach against, he used to always tell me when I was a young coach, Mike, you got to win the right game. You got to win the right game. And that's the key. You got to win the right game. The right game would be, in the playoffs.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
You talked about how you missed a few free throws, and especially because you guys were in the bonus pretty early in the second half. How hard is that to overcome, especially when you're facing a double-digit deficit and you're not making those free throws when you're getting to the line almost a couple times every few possessions?
Right. I mean, it's virtually impossible to overcome. I mean, on any level of basketball, whether it's Game 7 in the NBA Finals or whether it's the Anne Arundel County Championship, when you're fighting from behind and you have the opportunity to get the line, you have to make free throws. And not only does it add points to your score, but it gives you the ability to stop the game and get into your press. And I do think that we did effectively press them the last few minutes of the game and got a couple turnovers, almost turnovers. I thought that killed our momentum, and I thought that was the difference in us getting back into the game in the fourth quarter. I don't think it cost us the game because it didn't put us down by a couple figures, but it could have helped get us back into the game. So there's something we'll work on in practice, something we'll talk to the guys about.
I think it was early in that second half, you guys, I thought the press was, really effective. It was like a 9-point lead at the start of the second half. And then, you get a couple turnovers and buckets off of that and cuts it, and then they take off. And, when you're pressing is that effective, but you're not making the free throws, like you said, what are you trying to do as a coach in that situation?
We can't do anything other than say next play. I mean, that's all you can do is move on to the next play. Hopefully you can make a play and then either get back to the line or make a free throw. But, at the end of the day, I don't know if anybody has the free throw percentage or what we shot. I haven't looked at the scoreboard yet. But at the end of the day, I mean, that makes it really, really hard to get back into the game if you can't make your free throws. And like I said, we've been a good shooting team and a good free throw shooting team all season long, and we didn't shoot the ball today. It's the nature of basketball. That's why it's so exciting, March Madness, to get to a one-and-done scenario. But, the big picture is we did have a really good regular season, and that put us in position to host throughout the playoffs. Mm-hmm. So that is, for us, we do get rewarded for having a good season. And we played a Arundel at Arundel, and we played a Arundel at South River. We have not played a Arundel at Meade. So, again, not that that's going to happen, but if that does happen, it will be nice to play, our playoff games at home and get rewarded for having a good season. I think that could be a big difference for us.
And how much you pressured them to get free throws yesterday?
I'm sorry?
It's like, and how much you pushed them to make those free throws yesterday?
But Catherine, you're right, but at the same time, it's the players have got to step up and make the free throws, and it's making a free throw when you're in game number 5 in the middle of December is not like making a free throw. When you're in this environment, you're going to see it in college basketball. You're going to see it during March Madness. Kids that are 85% shooters are going to go up and miss. It's the nature of the game. It's the pressure of the game. And you can't simulate the pressure during the regular season. So, I think the one benefit that we do have is playing this game simulates a playoff atmosphere, simulates a championship environment. And I think our players will respond and grow from that. So, that's my take on it. But I've got to give Arundel a lot of credit. Rod did a great job coaching. I thought his team played exceptionally well. I thought his team shot the ball exceptionally well. I mean, Azeem is probably one of the best players, if not the best player in the county. Alters the game with his size. I think his size affected us. And I think the young man number 33, his name escapes me right now. Karis. I think Karis was fantastic. I mean, Karis was the best player on the court, and I think Karis had an exceptional game. I think Lockery had a very, very good game too. Shot the ball exceptionally well. So I think a lot of credit goes to Arundel too. I thought Arundel played very, very well. Might have been the best they played this season.
As long as it's you the next time, right?
Exactly. See, we regroup. We'll regroup, and they'll regroup, and we're all 0-0, and anything can happen in the playoffs. So.
Cool. Well, I hope I didn't distract y'all too much yesterday.
It distracts all. Yeah, I appreciate the coverage you're giving the kids. You wrote an awesome story, and thanks for all the coverage. And it's at the end of the day, I know it's high school sports. They're high school kids at the end of the day. This is a lifetime memory for them, win or lose. Our athletic director, Jamie Cook, who's a great athlete in Anne Arundel County and a state champion in basketball and a high-level Division I football player, he said the same thing happened to them when they won the state championship. They lost in the county, and when Meade won their state championship, they went undefeated during the season and they lost. And I just think, it's how you respond. It's how you respond. So I'll be shocked if our kids don't respond in a positive way. But thank you for the coverage, for all you. Thank you. Really, it means a lot to me and the kids. Thank you.
Yeah. All right, good luck to talk.